Number one overall pick Zion Williamson spoke to Complex about playing in New Orleans and how he'd like his NBA career to play out. So Pelican fans, take a listen. I'm going to try to give you the best answer I can give. Personally, I've always told myself I want to stay with one team. Growing up, I love what Kobe did and Dirk did. And I think if anybody's a Michael Jordan fan, they kind of erase the Wizards thing. Some people want to stay with one team, but they get traded. My intentions are to stay with the Pelicans my whole career. But if something happens, I wouldn't leave because I hate the place. It's just the business. Malika, this is obviously the right thing to say right now, but do you actually think he'll ultimately rethink the one team stance?
I don't want to pick him apart too much.
He's just a kid,
and I think that is absolutely the right thing to say. And I don't think that he's being disingenuous when he says that. I do think he, you know, it's great before you've played an NBA game to say that you want to stay in one place. One thing I will point out as a difference between some of the greats that he mentioned is that we're talking about the Bulls, we're talking about the Lakers, we're talking about the Mavs, but those are bigger market teams with winning history there. And the Pelicans don't have that. Now, I really like what they have done this offseason. I really like their new management, and potentially they could become, who's to say, they could become a giant in the NBA. But we're making some different decisions between really big market, flashy, shiny teams and smaller, you know, the Pelicans.
Yeah, to me, he's taken a page out of the Kyrie Irving handbook. And last year, for all the things Kyrie did that didn't go right, for the most part, up until basically All-Star break, it removed the question of will he or won't he want to stay, because he said, I want to stay. And it just quieted all that noise. Mm-hmm. And so if Zion puts that out there before people can start picking apart whether he's happy there or whether it's going to work there long term, it kind of just removes that from the conversation. Of course it's going to come up, you know, in 6 years or so, especially if he turns out to be the type of number one pick that we all think he can be. But for now, it's just like, okay, we don't need to talk about that. Let's talk about other stuff.
All right, so there are a couple of things here. Number one, when you first get in any relationship, right, you're going to love each other, right? You're in love. You're going to want to make sure that you profess that love repeatedly. And I think that's what he's doing. And that's smart, by the way. The other thing is, from a basketball perspective, David Griffin is really good at his job. He was a wizard this offseason, as you pointed out, Malika. And I think that Zion very quickly has seen that organization is run well. Now, he has no previous history as to how it was run before he arrived there, but I think David Griffin runs a tight ship, and I think that it's very obvious to him that it's similar in regards to maybe where he came from in college, where Mike Krzyzewski also runs a tight ship, and, you know, he sees the semblance between the two.
Yeah, and ultimately, we won't really know. I mean, it seems to be all these guys, especially if they're getting the compensation, the number one pick's getting, and they're getting the type of shoe deal that Zion's getting, it's not going to be come down to money. It's going to be come down to culture, come down to winning. And so if David Griffin, who has put together a great team on paper, can actually have it translate to wins, that'll be the determining factor.
They are a great League Pass team. I'm all in on them this year on League Pass.
Thanks so much for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports analysis and highlights, download the ESPN app. And for live streaming and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.